हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 8, डायरेक्ट शेयर टेस्ट. सो वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म द डायरेक्ट शेयर टेस्ट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी द डायरेक्ट शेयर बॉक्स. सो इफ यू कैन सी दिस पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्ट शेयर बॉक्स, सो विच इज हैविंग डिवाइडेड इनटू द टू पार्ट्स. सो दिस इज वन बॉटम वन पार्ट एंड दिस इज द टॉप पार्ट, बॉटम हाफ एंड टॉप हाफ. ओके, सो दिस बॉटम हाफ एंड टॉप हाफ इज कनेक्टेड यूजिंग दिस टू interlocking keys. This is called as an interlocking keys. So there are two interlocking keys which is connected diagonally at this point and at this point. Okay, so these are the two shearing plates that we have. Okay, so which are used for at the top and bottom of the soil sample. This is the base plate and this is the top loading plate. Okay, so for performance of the direct shear test today we are going to take a sand sample. So we have taken a sand sample. Now we will see the preparation of the direct shear box. So first of all, we will place the base plate. So this is the base plate that we are placing at the bottom. Okay. Now we are keeping the top half and then we are going to connect this top half and bottom half with these interlocking keys. Okay, so next to that we are placing the drainage plate. Okay. So this is how we have placed the drainage plate. Now we are going to put down a soil sample into the box. So this is the soil sample that we have taken. Okay. So now we have placed the sand sample into the direct shear box. Okay. And above that soil sample again we are placing another shear plate. Okay. So it should be like this. And above the shear plate we are going to place a loading pad where we are applying the normal load. So this is the preparation of the direct shear box. Now we have prepared the direct shear box and we are going to take this direct shear box to the apparatus for shearing. Now this is the channel, direct shear channel. So within this particular channel we are going to place this direct shear box. Okay, so this is the channel, within that we are going to place the. So this is how. So this is how we have to place the box. Now we will see the various components of the direct shear apparatus. So once we place this particular box, okay, so we will check it that it is correctly placed or not. Now this is the loading arm that we are going to place at the top of the direct shear box. Okay, so this is the loading arm. So okay, so ajun thoda sa rotate karo. We have to rotate that loading arm. Okay, now we can see over here. So there is the load that we can apply over here. Okay, this is of 0.5, 1 kg. Okay, doni taka. Okay, total 1 kg load that we are applying as a normal load. Okay, so this 1 kg load will get transferred to this particular loading arm. So it will be in the vertical downward direction. So this is the normal load, and the intensity of normal load is 1 kg per cm square, and which will remain constant throughout the test. Now we are going to apply the shear force. So shear force will apply through this particular knob, okay, and with some constant strain rate. Okay, so for that constant strain rate, we are going to use this particular two levers. So now you can see over here, there are two levers. Okay, this is lever A, this is lever B, and this is neutral, and this is the handle through which we can give the lever A or lever B or neutral. Okay, so what is the concept of lever A and B? So there is a one chart over here. So now you can able to see this chart. Okay, so there is a position of lever A or lever B, and these are the six gears, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So where are these six gears? So you can see this particular six gears over here. Okay, so this is the neutral one. 1, 2, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, there is 5 and 6, and again neutral. Okay, supposed to be right now the gear is at 1. Okay, and if I place this particular lever at the A, okay, so lever is at A and gear is at 1. So strain rate, I want to find out the strain rate. So from this particular chart, lever is at A and gear is 1. So strain rate is 1.25. It should be in mm per minute. Okay, so if I want to give this strain rate, supposed to be it is 0.005. So gear should be at the 4 and lever should be B. So according to that, we have to arrange the lever A and B. Okay, so arrangement of lever A and B should be accordance with this particular table. So there are various strain rates. For cohesive soil, we have to apply less strain rate. So for this, so you can see over here, less strain rates are there. So 0.004, 0.002, so likewise. For cohesionless soil, we have to apply the more strain rate. So we are giving the shear force with this particular knob over here. Okay, shear force. So when we are applying the shear force, the shear resistance is measured with this particular dial gauge. Okay, this is called as a proving ring. So if you see this particular proving ring, okay, so you can see the digits in the proving ring now. Okay, so it will start at 1, 2, 3, 4, and it will end at 20, 19, and again it will start at the 20. So we can able to record this resistance in that particular proving ring. So now we will apply the strain rate. So we will apply the same strain rate, that is 1.25. okay, so you can check here. So if I want to apply the strain rate is 1.25, my gear should be at 1 and lever should be at A. So I will check it. Okay, you can check over here. The gear is at 1 and the lever is at A. Okay, so before starting it, I want to remove these interlocking keys. Okay, so it is very important to remove the interlocking keys. Okay, make sure that your dial gauge should be at the 0. Okay, so I will make, okay, this is 0. Okay, so it should be at the 0. Now I will start this particular machine and I will apply the strain rate. Okay. Yes, okay. Now we are applying the strain rate and the normal stress is remaining constant, that is 1 kg per cm square, and we can able to record this particular strain rate. Okay, so this is how we have to perform this. So you can check the movement of the needle. So likewise we have to record the readings.